The European Union was based on the idea, and we boast with the idea of shared values. Well, honestly, and let's not fool ourselves, we are already struggling with creating values. Mario Draghi may see that a little different. Let's see how many bazookas he has left. A different topic of values comes also into the play here. And that's the question whether our convictions, our inherited intellectual approaches, and yes, our values are strong enough to counter the cynical simplicity of fear, of economic despair, and of fundamentalism. And that's a value question we should resolve as a European Union, and we shouldn't be too apologetic about what we have created, not only over the last couple of decades, but over centuries. On paper, the concept of the European Union, and I do still endorse it wholeheartedly, you may think differently with all these slides, looks lovely. Freedom, rule of law, respect for human rights, equality, democracy. But Michael Gove has a point. We are in probably the most profound democracy crisis the Western world has seen so far. But this is not only a democracy crisis that we can link to the construct of the European Union, which has elements of a democracy crisis. It is a democracy crisis we see more or less in every single nation state of the Western world. May it be in the US, may it be in Germany, maybe in Austria, or even in the UK. The question of sclerotic institution, the question of populism, the question of more and more distance of the people towards the so-called establishment, hate towards the establishment, is nothing that's only caused by the European Union or by European ideas. It's something we see more or less everywhere right now in our Western world.